Monica, how the program was a research-oriented policy measure introduced in 2001 in Spain. This program was aimed at attracting young PhD researchers of high quality into Spanish research centers. When it was introduced, there was a pervasive perception of significant brain drain in the Spanish research system, lack of research career paths for young researchers, and also inbreeding in many Spanish research centers. A novelty of the Ramón y Cajal program is that it was focused on employability rather than trainings, and this makes different from most research-oriented programs. In fact, it provided a 5-year contract provided to the grant recipients, a 5-year contract in the Spanish Research Center, as well as the opportunity of achieving a permanent position in such research center. Our question in this paper is what is the effect of the Ramón y Cajal program in the scientific productivity of researchers. For that purpose, we evaluate the scientific productivity in a window of 4 years after the call, and measure the number of publications, the quantity of research, as well as the impact of the publication, the quality of the research. It must be said that the Ramón y Cajal was a competitive program, so that the selection process was accomplished through a centralized and transparent process in which a peer review assessment was implemented. This process was external to the two research centers. Precisely for this reason, the contact status is obviously not random, as it is positively correlated with the productivity of the researcher. For this reason, the naive difference in average productivity between applicants with a contract and applicants without a contract does not provide a consistent measure of the causal effect of the contract. This is well known as a selection bias. Basically, the idea is that even in the absence of the contract, we would expect the Ramón y Cajal researchers to be more productive than those without a contract. So what we must do is to compare researchers that at the time of the call were alike, except for the fact that one of them received a contract and the other did. Our estimation methods are the conditional regression and the non-parametric matching estimation. And the results that we obtain are quite similar. Basically, we can summarize as follows. We find a positive and significant effect of the contract on both the quantity and the quality of the research. Basically, to give some numbers, we find that those with the contract have on average between 20 and 26% papers more, between 15 and 17% higher average impact, and between 10 and 15% higher maximum impact of the research. The results support policies aim at fostering career prospect to young researchers as a way to raise the weight of the science and technology Spanish system into the worldwide research. That's all.